first project. And Vev, let's go through the interface of the tool. So right now you're looking at your Vev dashboard. A dashboard is where you can see and manage your projects, drafts, and templates. You can also create teams and workspaces. Anytime you want to get back to your dashboard when you're inside of project, you can always click on the Vev icon in the top left corner of your screen. For each project, you have different options for editing depending on your role. You can choose to edit the content of a project, which allows you to focus on editing text, images, and videos. If you click on Edit Design, you can then edit the look and functionality of your site. Once you are in a project via the design editor, you can then leverage Vev's code editor to further develop the functionality of your site. There are two ways to create a project in Vev. The first way is to click on this blue plus icon next to drafts, or you can simply click on the Create Project button in the top right corner. You'll then be prompted to create a project either from a blank canvas or from a template. Let's go ahead and click on blank project. From here, you can choose the layout and size of your project. For now, let's stick with desktop first. Now we're inside of our project. Like I mentioned before, you can always get back to your dashboard by clicking on the Vev icon in the top left corner of the screen. Next, you have your pointer, which is what you use to move things around and select different elements. Next, you have this plus icon, which opens up a menu of all the different features that you can add to your project. From there, we have an icon to add sections to your project. Then you have the ability to add text, images, video, and shapes. You'll notice with images, you can see the different image types that you can add, as well as open your image library. Same with the video icon and the shapes icon. When you add something to your canvas, you'll notice that three additional icons pop up here. The first one allows you to create a main component. The second one allows you to swap sections, or if you have an image, you can swap images out very easily by pressing this. Next, you have a button to attach an add-on to an element. For the sake of example, let's add an animation to this text box. And now you'll see a fourth button appear, which allows you to manage the animation for that element. You can also do this on the left-hand panel by clicking on the animation symbol as well. Over here, we have the zoom tool, which allows you to zoom in and out or just reset the zoom. Next, you can view your project across different display sizes. The eyeball allows you to preview your project. And the next three icons allow you to access the design editor, which we're already in, the content editor, and the code editor. Lastly, this blue button on the top right allows you to publish your button. Next, we can name our project. Here, we can add tags, change our page cover, turn on and off guides, set our project colors, and see the different sizes that we're working with across our project. On the left-hand side, this name is auto-generated by Vev. You can go ahead and click on it to rename that. Once you start creating new pages, you can use these two arrows to navigate back and forward. This allows you to reload your page, and this button allows you to see an overview of all the pages of your project. You'll notice that you can set the status of each page, and only the ones that are done will be published when you go to publish your project. From here, this is where you manage the different sections and elements of your project. Zooming out, you'll notice these two bars around the canvas. This allows you to quickly change the size of your canvas to the different display sizes. At this point, you probably have noticed these two dotted blue lines here. This encloses the safe zone for your project. To play it safe, With designing across screen sizes, Vev recommends keeping all of your content within these two blue lines. When you start putting elements outside of this safe zone, you'll notice that these blue lines turn red. When you click into a section of your project, you'll notice that the right-hand panel changes, which allows you to control the design and look of each section and the elements within it. So now that you have an overview of the Vev design editor, let's go ahead and design our first project.